Hi everyone, hope you are doing well. In this video, we are going to set up the application insights for our backend application. Now, what exactly is application insight? It's the insight of your application. So this video is a part of a series called a software engineering bootcamp. But don't worry, if you are not part of the series, still you will be able to understand what exactly I'm doing here. So this is a backend service which I have hosted here. So I have hosted the service in Azure, and then you can actually access the service using the endpoint. So my service name is ecommerce backend/healthcheck, and we are able to access the health check from here. Likewise, there is a code base for the same. I'll give the link to the code base as well for which the deployment happens. So these things are already configured in Azure, that I have configured the GitHub link. I have given the GitHub link to the Azure. And then what Azure does is that it pulls the code from GitHub and deploys to the endpoint, that is this endpoint. How exactly all these things happen, I have covered in the previous videos. I'll put the link in the description. So these things are already set up. Now the thing is, we want to have some insights about our application. By insight, I mean how many requests are coming to my backend service per second, or what is the latency to my backend service? What are the various calls which are happening to my backend service? So there are many things which you would want to know about your application. There are two ways you could do that. One is that you can write some code. So I already have my Java code written here. I could write some extra code and then get these insights. But if you're putting your code in Azure, and here Azure is responsible to host your code online, so in those cases, you don't have to worry a lot about these issues. So these things are given to you by default, out of the box, by Azure, without making any line of code changes. So that's what we'll do here. So we have this Azure app service running with us here for the code base, which is deployed here without making any code change. We'll go to the application insight section. And then what we'll do is that we'll turn on the application insight. You see, and the location is South India because that's where I'm located. And then I'll just click on apply. And my application insight, the application is Java based. So it by default selects the Java application insight. So that's what it's choosing. So I am creating a new resource and then I'm clicking on apply. So we'll wait a little for the application insight to get created, and then we'll go to that resource. So you see the deployment is in progress. That is a service which is responsible for all the application insight. It is getting created, which will monitor everything. So that's done. Now we can click on go to resource and see the things happening here. So you see the application insight for my application got created. That's an instrumentation key. It will be important for the upcoming videos, but for now it's not important. Don't worry, I'll change it later. It's a secret key, don't share it with anyone. Here I'll actually mask it or delete it. So this is the application which is created, and it has a bunch of things for our application. Now what exactly I'll do is that I'll go to my application and do a bunch of operations so that you can actually see the changes. Like you see the number of failed requests, server response times, the requests coming to your server, and the availability. So bunch of things you will be able to see by default. So what I'll do is that just now we have configured everything, right? So I'll go to my application and do a bunch of operations, nothing fancy. I'll just click on reload. I might do a bunch of clicks here and there. So let me do that. Alright, it took some time for the changes to get reflected. Maybe that's the reason it scales so fast. All the operations are almost asynchronous. So here you can see this e-commerce application insight is able to show the results. For example, the server response time. You can see the server response time initially was 3 seconds and then it is nearly 0 milliseconds. So these insights are generally very helpful without any code change. The server requests, the number of server requests coming to your server, those patterns also you can see. You can click on application dashboard as well. And here you can see a bunch of things. Let me just reload the page for you. You can see the things like server response time, 619 milliseconds in the past 24 hours. You could even change the time range from past 24 hours to, let's say, past 30 minutes. And you can see the pattern of the server response time. Likewise, you can see the failed request. You can see average processor or the CPU utilization as well. So there are a bunch of things you can see directly from here. And you can configure those things. I'm not going to get into the details. I was just wanting to share that there are things you can configure yourself very easily. I'll click on cancel here and I'll close it. Let's go back. So we have configured the dashboard. And in the dashboard, the second thing which I would want to show you is the metric. So here you can check out the individual metric as well. Let's first see the process CPU. You can see the CPU usage is also being shown here. Around 9% was the CPU usage here because we just now started the things, right? You can also configure the availability by going to the availability section here. And then here you can actually add the test cases that how do you want to confirm that the server is available or not. For that, you can click on this classic test case, write health check. And in my service, I already have a health check endpoint, right? I'll just copy it from here and then I'll paste it here. So it will keep on pinging this endpoint to confirm whether the service is up or not. I can also change the time frequency and then I click on create. So now the availability will be configured and it will keep on pinging my endpoint. And if this endpoint is working, it will say that your service is available. Otherwise, it will say your service is not available. As simple as that. So now, once this is configured, you can actually go and reload the page and see your data. Or you can go to the availability section and there also you can see the data. So let me, you see average availability is now 100%. So you can configure things like these. Now let's just click on the application insight again. And here the last thing I wanted to show you is the logs. So the logs can help you to figure out a lot of things. So here you see a bunch of logs being populated for your application. So here you can type a bunch of things. For example, if you want to see what are the requests coming to your server, you can just type request and then click on run. And you see all the requests coming to your server are logged here so that you can see what are the count of the request. In fact, you can do like summarize count and it will give you all the count of the requests coming to your server. You see, there is something called as dependencies, which actually tells you the number of calls your service is making to some other service. So those things, these are the three calls which are there for no reason, but once we code, so there are more things which will come up and show you. Let me show you in the Xcali draw actually. So you see, the request is something which is coming to your server. So you have a backend service. In our case, this is ecommerce backend Anubhav. So the request is something which is coming and it will be HTTP here. And the dependency will be something where we are making the call. We might be making call to some other service. We might be making call to some database. So those will be the dependencies. So you can, the dependencies will be the external dependency, the request will be the request coming to your server. So you can get the count of both. These are the three dependencies for now. And the request you could see here, these are the request. Likewise, you can actually see the exceptions as well. So if there is any exception, I don't think there would be any exception. But just in case if there are some exceptions, you can see directly here. The traces is something which you configure in your code, like the trace logs. Like logger.info, logger.error. So those actually come here. So let's see for now. So you see, there is something which is coming up to our server, like the logs. This is error, this is warn, Some of the things we configured in the other video, logger.info, logger.error. So those things are showing up in our logs directly. So that is also one good thing, that the log, the logging which we did on a Spring Boot application in the previous video using logger.info, logger.error. So those things are also showing up here, and with the severity level and a bunch of other things. So here you could even have filters like where severity level is equal to 1. So here only the severity level 1 will be shown. Likewise, you can have a severity level 2 is for warning, 3 is for error. More the number, higher is the severity level. So those things are configured here. So you could even run the query like this, and it's just like a SQL query. So it's very helpful. In fact, you can actually read about all the different types of queries like summarize and all those things in the Kusto query language. You can search like Kusto query language, and here by Microsoft, this is something which is responsible for querying things here. So yeah, you can configure a bunch of things here directly and get the logs, like the severity level 1 is 1 log. So you can see, you can do a lot of things on the application insights directly. The logs are coming, the things like dependencies are coming, the things like the traces and the requests coming to your server, they are getting logged directly. So here you can actually just query and see the amount of time it took. So you have success equal to true, the time and the duration for the APIs, how many milliseconds it took for the response to show up, and then the performance bucket so that you can bucketize your things. So a lot of things are showing up here directly, and which will help you to analyze your data. There is one thing called as alerts as well, which you can configure, but I'm not going to configure them in this video. Actually, there are so many features that it is almost not possible to explain everything, but you can actually create alert, and then you can send mail to yourself based on various factors, that if the availability is below certain number, then send me mail. So those things can also be configured. But I would recommend to explore all the features which are available here, and rather than me explaining, but I just wanted to explain you the capability of the tool here overall. That was my intent. The logging is very helpful, the log thing. So whenever an issue comes up, you can just come here and see various traces coming to your service, like trace with the severity 1. So that will be actually very helpful. So yeah, that's it from my side for this video. I hope this video was helpful. In the upcoming video, I'll have one video on how to get more smart around the application insights by making bunch of code changes. But I think this one is very rudimentary and very helpful, but that the next one will be even more smart. So check out that video as well. But I hope this video was helpful. I hope you were able to understand application insight and the advantage of using Azure as your application or as your platform provider or the cloud provider, so that you just give the code base and it is able to give you the logs as well. So yeah, that's it from my side for this video. Till the next time, bye.